to be in yellow, it's for me it was a really big surprise. It just showed me that I had done some great work and achieved some of my goals. I think I've gotten some new respect of the yellow jersey because that's the symbol of consistency. My strengths as a biathlete, that's really hard to answer actually, because I'm not really good in anything. If you split biathlon into parts, I'm average at everything. But put it together, it's I'm quite good at sometimes. The level in biathlon now is at its highest level of all time. Maybe I just say it because I think it's hard to be on the top, but I really believe so, because you know when you're on start that you have to do a perfect race to be up there, and in biathlon you learn to stay humble, because you know that there's if you miss a shot, then you're 10 places down, and it's really hard to be in the top. And this year I've even more seen how hard it is to be to have the yellow jersey. You know, Emil Helge Svensson, yes, he's now like this expert in NRK, and he even said yesterday that the women competition is much more exciting than the boys. So I believe so too. Having fun is like the part one, and then you can put the work and everything on top of that. And if you lose the bottom part of having fun and loving biathlon and enjoying what you do, it's really hard to have your mind at the right place. At least for me, if I depend too much on the biathlon results, there's no chance that I will hit the targets. I went straight to the A team in Norway, and the first year was really tough for me. I felt that I only got the spot because there were maybe not so many else. But if you're young and not in shape and everything in World Cup, you get really hard punished. You don't get a lot of confidence, but I think that maybe it would have been at least fun for me to be a bit more in the IBU Cup. You can be at the start fighting for top 10 or for the podium. But I mean, it somehow worked for me. I'm still in the World Cup. I don't see my teammates as rivals. If I get in a situation where it's between Marte, Tiril, or any of my other teammates and I, that's like the perfect situation to be in. So before it's like the four of us and only three on the podium, it's not a problem, it's more of like a luxury problem, if you can say that in English. I don't know, it's in Norwegian you say that. For us, it's just a very big win for the whole team that we can be many girls up there, and I think we build a lot of confidence. I don't know, I hope to, of course, be more consistent in biathlon, and I've, of course, tried to be better and do things better and learn by my mistakes and develop. You know, you live the same life every year. We go to Oberhof and then we go to Rubolding and then we go to Antals, and it's like the same schedule. So I guess I just see myself in the same situation as now. I'll just sit in this chair with hopefully so many more good results in the next years, I guess.